Myself Balasubramaniam and I am going to explain about the regulated power supply, that is regulated DC power supply. And so coming to the first, what is the importance of regulated DC power supply? So if we get household current like AC, that is alternating current, which is of 230 volts, but we in our daily life we use different types of electronic circuits, that is electronic gadgets, for example our mobile phone. But electronic devices works with the DC power supply only, so we need to convert that 230 volts of AC voltage into the DC required level. For that we use the regulated DC power supply. So the regulated power supply, example for a regulated power supply is our adapter. For example, adapter used for charging our mobile phone. So what are the different blocks involved in that particular regulated power supply I am going to explain here. So the block diagram of regulated DC power supply is, first block involved here is a transformer. So here for the transformer we are applying the 230 volts AC power supply, 230 volts AC power supply. So here the first stage is the transformer, and which is a type of step down transformer. The output of the step down transformer is given to the rectifier. The output of the step down transformer is given to the rectifier. After the rectifier, after completion of rectification process, this output of the rectifier is given to the filter circuit. After that, the output of the filter circuit is given to the last stage, and which is most important stage, that is voltage regulator stage. So the output of the voltage regulator, we get the whatever the we required, that is constant DC output. Constant DC output. So these are the main blocks involved in the regulated power supply, that is regulated DC power supply. So initially we are applying the for transformer. Here I am using a step down transformer. That is here for step down transformer I am applying 230 volts AC supply. That 230 volts AC power supply is stepped down to the, for example, here I am using a 909 type of transformer, then this 230 volts voltage is stepped down to the 9 volts AC. So output of this transformer is 9 volts AC. So 230 volts to 9 volts step down is occurred here. After that, this output, that is the 9 volts, for example I am considering it as a 9 volts AC, this 9 volts AC I am giving to the rectifier circuit. So here most important and which is the application of a diode, PN junction diode, is the rectifier. So rectifier is a circuit which converts the AC signal into the pulsating DC. So AC signal into pulsating DC. Rectifier is a circuit which is used to convert the AC signal into the pulsating DC signal. So here we use different types of rectifiers depending on the application. So normally in our circuitry, that is in our adapter, we use the bridge type of rectifier. But normally rectifiers are classified into half wave rectifier, full wave rectifier. So full wave rectifiers are further classified into center tapped transformer, full wave rectifier. So here I am using, in this circuitry we use a center tapped transformer, that's why it is center tapped type of full wave rectifier. And second one is the bridge wave rectifier, bridge type of rectifier. Since here I am using a in this circuitry we use a four diodes in the bridge manner, that's why it is called as the bridge type of rectifier circuitry. So normally we use bridge type of rectifier for constructing the this rectifier circuit in regulated DC power supply. So here I am applying the for rectifier circuit, I am applying a AC voltage, and but after rectification process we get pulsating DC. Pulsating DC means DC voltage plus with some amount of the AC component, that is the output. This output consists of major part of DC but some amount of minor amount of the AC component. So but for our application we just don't want any AC component, so we need to remove the this AC component. So for removing this AC component we simply use a filter circuit. So filter circuit. So filter is a circuit which is used to remove the AC. So filter. Filter is a circuit which is used to remove the AC component in the pulsating DC. So for filter we are applying an input from the output of the rectifier is applied as an input to the filter circuitry, so which is a pulsating DC. Then this filter removes the AC component and gives the pure DC. So the efficiency of filter depends on the type of filter. So we use different types of filter. So for example we have capacitor type filter, second one is the inductor type filter, and third one is the L section filter. And third fourth one is the pi section filter. So first one is the capacitor type of filter, that is I am using for filter purpose I am using a capacitor. If you use a inductor then that is a inductor type of filter. If you use the both the combination, that is if you use the capacitor and a combination with the inductor, then it forms a L section. For example a capacitor and an inductor, so simply it is like an L type of structure, that's why it is called as a L section filter. If I am using the one more inductor here, so this arrangement like that, it's like a pi shape, that's why it is a pi section filter. So these are the different filters used in the regulator power supply. After that, so after filter process we get the purest DC, but the output another stage is there. The last stage and most important stage is the voltage regulator stage. So voltage regulator is a circuit which maintains constant output even though there is a changes in the AC power supply or the resistance of the load we are connecting this adapter. So voltage regulator is most important because whenever any fluctuations occur in the AC power supply, the circuitry protection or the device protection depends only on the voltage regulator circuitry. So this voltage regulator is mainly constructed by using the G0 diode. When it operated in reverse bias condition and when maintain it in breakdown region, then it acts as a voltage regulator. By using that particular principle we construct the voltage regulator so in normal case, in practical case we also use some ICs like 7805. So 7805 also one of the example for the voltage regulator IC. So which gives the output plus 5 volts, constant 5 volts output. So this is the main these are the main blocks consist in the regulator DC power supply. So coming to the circuitry, for example So coming to the circuitry, first stage is a transformer. For this, we are applying the 230 volts AC and step down transformer. Number of turns in the secondary coil are less as compared to the primary coil. After that, rectifier stage. So for rectification purpose, I am using a bridge rectifier. And this is the rectifier circuit. After that, I am going to connect a capacitor filter here. So, which is a filter. After that, a 7805 voltage regulator. And here, output. And which is of plus 5 volts DC. Right, so D1, D2, D3, D4. So here it is a step down transformer. And this circuit is a rectifier circuit. And here I am using capacitor for filter purpose. Capacitor filter, I am using here capacitor filter. And it is a voltage regulator. So this is the actual circuitry of the regulator DC power supply. So this is the actual circuit involved in the our adapter circuitry. So coming to the waveforms, here initially it is a 230 volt AC signal. After that, the output of this transformer is a, for example, I am using a 909 type of transformer. It gives a 9 volts of AC signal. So after the rectification process, in between these terminals, I will get a pulsating DC output here. Output of the rectifier. So this output of rectifier, that is pulsating DC, is applied to the capacitor filter. So after the capacitor filter, the output will be like this, that is a constant output. So this constant output we apply to the 7805 voltage regulator. This voltage regulator maintains the constant output even though there is changes, fluctuations in this signal. Even though there is any changes in this signal, but the 7805 maintains a constant output. So automatically output of this 7805 is a 5 volts DC signal, constant signal. So this is the actual working and the different blocks and different circuit elements involved in the regulator DC power supply. So in these days, in our every aspects, that is in our households or any applications involved in the gadgets, mobile phones, laptops, all any electronic components, everything, for every for working of any electronic component depending on the DC power supply. So for that we need to maintain this circuitry. For every circuit, electronic circuit consists of this circuitry. Right? Thank you.